The community here in Santa Fe is focused on healing. Today, a memorial service was held for the victims. As crews arrived to set up for the event, an emotional sight. Take a look at this, a rainbow which appeared directly over the church. One person saying that it looked like it was coming from Santa Fe High School. And on a day like today, you can imagine the added significance. Joining me now are three students who attend Santa Fe High School, Taylor Burns, Alexis Wilson, Harley Canales. We appreciate all of you taking some time for us. So Taylor and Harley, you're in your caps and gowns because you just came from that baccalaureate ceremony. I know you did too, Alexis. You went home to change a little bit. This is a lot, to put it mildly, for you guys over the last 48 hours or so. Right. And Taylor, I know your dad and your brother were actually two of the first responders who were there pretty quickly on scene. And they called you from the school?
No, my dad got the call and he called my mom, and I was on my way to school and she told me not to go, and he said that there's active shooter at the high school, not to go to school.
That must have been almost surreal in the moment.
Yes, it was so scary. Yeah. First thing I did was call all my friends. They didn't even have no idea until I called them. It was just, it happened so fast.
Were some of the friends that you called, were they inside the school or were they on their way like you were?
I called her too. They were in the school, and then they were walking out because they thought it was a fire drill, and they weren't going to run until I told them that it was a shooter.
So it's pretty important calls that you made.
Yes.
Yeah. Alexis, when we were talking earlier, you were saying how last night you'd just been praying for some sort of a sign. And you woke up this morning and you saw that rainbow.
Yeah, I was praying all last night and just asking, like, why, God, why? I just didn't understand why something like this would happen to us. And so I was just asking for some sign to just show me that we're going to be okay and that they've made it to the other side. So when I seen that rainbow this morning, I just knew that everybody had made it with him and that he's with our town and we're going to be okay.
I know that you, Harley, actually had class with the suspect.
Yes, I did.
How would you describe him?
Very quiet. He was always quiet. He never really had anything to say. He would just sit in the back of the room, get his work done, turn his work in, and sit back there, listen to music, sleep, play on the computer. He never said anything. He was never friendly with anyone, but he was never rude to anybody. Mm-hmm. He was just quiet.
You weren't at school that morning because you actually graduated early.
Yes,
after last year. But you were telling me earlier you almost feel guilty.
I
that
do.
You weren't here.
Yeah, I feel very guilty. I feel like I should have been there, not guilty, like I should have been there, it should have been me, but I do feel that way. I feel like I should have been able to run with my friends. I feel awful that I wasn't there to be there with them physically. I had to get texts from my best friend that she was running because she had heard shots. I had to get texts, like I had to text people to make sure they were okay, and I just felt like I should have been there to be with everyone that I grew up with and that I was close with.
That's a lot to hear from somebody who just graduated high school.
Yeah.
Alexis, your family is very close with the family of Chris Stone, who we know is one of the victims. I know you've been in touch with the Stone family. Your family obviously grieving too. How's everyone holding up?
I don't want to speak for his family, but for my family, it's been really hard. We just want to be with them and let them know that we're there for them and that, not that it'll be okay because it won't for a long time, but that together we'll all be there for them and just, we have them in their prayers.
Tell us about Chris.
He was a very nice, sweet kid. I wouldn't, like, done anything. Like, he was nice, kind, and he did anything for everybody. Like, I grew up with him since I was really, before I could even remember, and we spent every summer together. We went to Schlitterbahn, we had season passes. We'd go every Monday. I went to Six Flags with them, and I rode a roller coaster for the first time with them because they talked me into it, and he just had a heart of gold. He was very sweet.
From the people that we've met over the last couple of days, people that we've spoken to, this seems like a pretty tight-knit community. How are you guys putting your arms around each other? What are you doing to try to help the people who are grieving right now?
Just being there for everyone as much as we can. We're all coming together.
You have a lot of the details, I know, from your brother about what he saw and what he experienced. How hard is it for you to know those things at this point? He gave you some pretty graphic details.
Mm-hmm. It's hard. I mean, I didn't know that he was going in the school. I was scared, like, what if they didn't find another bomb? Like, what could have happened to him? What if there was another shooter? Like, it was just scary knowing that he could have been one of the ones that was shot.
What did he tell you about what that was like for him?
I don't know. I can't go into detail what he told me, but he did say it was very hard. And
hard on him.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's a lot to process, especially in a community where you likely may know some of those people. Taylor, you're saying it's, or Harley, rather, just to be here and to look at the school, that's a lot for you.
Yeah.
Right now.
Yeah, it's very hard. It's a very eerie feeling to be here, knowing that people I grew up with and that a lot of people I know were close with, and knowing that they didn't make it out of that school on Friday was just awful. It's an awful feeling. I don't think anyone should ever have to step foot back on this in that school again.
I actually went into the school yesterday, and it was one of the hardest things I've ever done, to see everything just left the way it was, and my papers, my water, everything. It was so hard, and to see the doors have be broken down and have C2 on them to be cleared, like, I just don't understand why it happened to us.
You were escorted in groups of 10 yesterday to get your belongings.
I walked in by myself with the officer. Me and my mom went in. We were one of the first ones to go in, and it was just, I can't explain to y'all how it was. It was just a feeling that I've never felt, ever.
Did the officer try to prepare you for what you might see?
Not really. He was there for us, but I mean, he's kind of being stern. It's his job, and he knows. He like had to follow procedure, so he was kind of just there, and he let me cry and let me just do what I did.
School, in theory, could resume on Wednesday. You've all said you don't want to go back in that building.
I won't go back. I don't think any of us should walk back in there knowing that we get to continue school, but they can't. It's just, I don't think so. I don't think we should have to go back in there and deal with it.
It's a lot for you guys. We really appreciate you taking the time to speak with us. Thank you.
Thank you.